This video is about our two post lifts. The two post lifts are divided in three different subcategories, so to speak. On the one hand, we have the basic line models. On the other, the profi line models and the heavy line models. Let's start with the basic line models. We have four different models in this case. The TW242A, like the one we have here, the TW242G, the TW242AFZ, and the TW242E. A brief explanation of the name. Here we have the 242A, which means two post lift, 4.2 tons lifting capacity in this case, and A. What does A mean? It's our starter model. What does starter model mean? In this case, we have a manual safety release here.
Manuelle Entriegelung, das heißt, an beiden meiner.
That means there's a steel cable on each carriage. When I pull on it, a little safety is released on the back here. And then I can lower the lift with the release lever on the side here. It also works like this with the 242G, which also means two post lift, 4.2 tons. G stands for garage model. The difference is simply that the lift is built a bit smaller, a bit shorter, so that it fits in a completely normal garage. Also equipped with a manual safety release. It's a bit different with the 242AFZ. It looks basically the same as the TW242A, with the small difference that it is completely galvanized. That means, intended for outdoor use, or also damp rooms such as car washes or the like. As mentioned, the lift is completely galvanized, and it doesn't have a fixed control and motor unit like this model here, but rather a mobile one. That means I get a small trolley with the lift. The whole unit is connected via a quick connector and a plug. Which means, when I want to disconnect the control unit from the lift, then I simply have to pull the plug, release the quick connector, and after that I can push away the control unit into safety inside the garage, the house or wherever, while the lift stays outside. A few words about the 242E now. 242E means two posts, 4.2 tons. E stands for electromagnetic safety release. What is that? We are still standing here by the 242A. Here we see what I already mentioned before with this hydraulic lever. Here we have a very normal control unit, relatively uncluttered. We have an up button with which the lift can be driven up, an emergency off button to disconnect the lift from the power supply, and a main switch to turn the lift on and off. Here's the 230 volt motor. All of our basic line lifts are equipped with a 230 volt motor. All of this looks a bit different on the 242E, and on the 242G and 242AFZ as well. With the 242E, it's like this. The motor is no longer needed here due to the electromagnetic release. This lever is not needed either. That means, the motor is moved up, and the control unit comes a bit down, and I get an additional down button, with which I can lower the lift solely by pressing the button. And I also get a lock button to lower the lift onto the next safety catch. That can be done with the 242A as well by not unlocking the lift, and simply pushing the hydraulic lever to lower the lift onto the next safety catch. On the 242G, the garage model, all of this looks almost the same. Just a little bit different. Because the 242G is used for relatively small spaces, we decided to move the motor and the control unit to the front. That means it's placed here on the front of the lift. We have asymmetrical lifting arms for both our basic line and our profi line lifts. Asymmetric means, here's our rear lifting arm, which is longer, and here's our front arm, which is shorter. This is designed like this because if I have a car with front motor, with front wheel drive, it logically has a lot more weight on the front. So I always have to shift the weight a little bit towards the center of the lift. which wouldn't work so well with symmetrical lifting arms with the same length. That's why we chose to build shorter front arms, so that the weight distribution works a bit better.
Kürzere zu verbauen, dass halt einfach die Gewichtsverteilung ein bisschen besser funktioniert.
All of our basic line models have one-stage lifting pads. That means they are plugged in here, and I can turn them upwards once. The Profi line always builds up on the basic line. Therefore, the basic line can lift the same vehicles as the 4.2-ton Profi line. Here, in the case of the 4.2-ton lift, I have a vehicle range of use from the smallest car, meaning truly from a smart, up to a sprinter with medium wheelbase. Things start to get a little complicated with long wheelbases, that's why we have our heavy line products available. But the most common vehicles, whether it's a Golf, an Audi R6, or something else in this category, can all be lifted effortlessly with this lift. The 242A is also available as 242AG. It's basically the same identical lift, with the same structural design and everything, with the small difference that the A is offered in blue, and the AG is grey, anthracite. All of our two-post lifts have a maximum lifting height of 1.9 meters, except for the TW242G. With the 242G it is 1.6 meters. Let's focus on our Profi line models. Here are our 4.2-ton and our 3.6-ton Profi line lifts. What are the differences between a Profi line and a basic line lift? There are different aspects. Let's start with that which we can already see. For example, here we have the extension adapters. If I have a van or a ladder frame vehicle, for example, the adapter simply helps me to generate some distance between my lifting arm and my lifting point. It's often the case that the door sills are lower than the lifting point, therefore, I must go higher first so that I can lift my vehicle without damaging it. Besides that, all Profi line lifts are equipped with these brackets for the extension adapters. They are made for two adapters on each side. We also have two-stage lifting pads on all our Profi line models. That means I have a fine thread here and a coarse thread there, which allows me to turn the pad more easily. And the pad has a greater adjustment range than the one-stage lifting pad. Besides that, our Profi line lifts have a post protection cover, which is there to protect the inside of the post, especially when I have recently greased the pulleys, etc., so that dirt doesn't come in again. It simply protects the inside of the post and it also looks a bit better. Since we're already discussing the optics, all of our Profi line lifts have a standard motor cover, which simply covers the whole motor unit, the oil tank, etc. The things I just mentioned here, the extension adapters and also the post protection covers can be easily equipped to the basic line models. Of course, also the two-stage lifting pads and so on, everything that can be replaced can be bought for the basic line models. Now we're by the control unit, there are some differences here as well. What's immediately noticeable when compared to the basic line, all Profi line models have a 230-volt connection here, where I can connect my angle grinder, for example, or any other tool. Besides that, this control unit has an up button, a down button and a lock button like the one from the 242E. Here we can clearly see the electromagnets. There are two on each post and they're responsible for the electromagnetic safety release of the lift. Something special from the Profi line is the anti-lift up button system. It's generally known that when you push the down button on hydraulic lifts, the lift goes up a bit first before it moves down. This is not the case with the anti-lift up button system. If I push this button combination, here first and after that the down button, then the lift goes down directly, as long as it was not lowered onto the locking position before, onto the next safety catch. Up here, it can be seen quite well, we have a plug. All ProfiLine models can be equipped here with a quick connection for compressed air, where I can connect an impact wrench or similar tools, for example. A quick word about the differences between the 4.2 and 3.6 ton models. There are no significant distinctions. Logically, the 3.6 ton has 600 kilograms less lifting capacity than the 4.2 ton. Furthermore, the 3.6 ton model has shorter lifting arms on the front, which is a great advantage when lifting vehicles from BMW or Mini.
Im Bereich bei Fahrzeugen aus dem Hause BMW oder Mini.
We've had very good experiences with these arms, explicitly with the BMW lines 1 to 3 and Mini Cooper. Because the arms are considerably shorter, the lifting points can be reached more easily. Our 3.6 and 4.2 ton ProfiLine lifts are also available as clear floor models. What does clear floor mean? There's a floor plate on this model, under which the steel cables responsible for the synchronization and the hydraulic lines pass through. With the clear floor models, this whole area is completely free and the cables and line pass through a crossbeam above. This has the benefit of leaving this space completely free, a free passage, which is a great advantage when I want to walk under the car with a tool trolley, for example, or an oil collector or something similar. Then I don't have to overcome this barrier here, of course. However, clear floor models are logically relatively tall, otherwise they wouldn't be able to lift every car easily. The 3.6 ton model has a total height of 3.9 meters and the 4.2 ton has a height of 4.3 meters. This means that, logically, at least these dimensions are required in the garage for me to be able to install these lifts there. Otherwise, only the two models with floor plate, which have a height of almost 3 meters, would fit. All of our ProfiLine 2 post lifts are equipped with a 400 volt motor. The 4.2 ton model is also available in 230 volts on request, with normal household current, but only the normal one. The clear floor model is only available in 400 volts. Last but not least, our heavy line lifts. The heavy line includes both the TW250 and also the TW260. Again, as with the naming before, two posts, 5 tons, is the 250. And two posts, 6 tons is the 260. Both of them are also available as clear floor models with a total height of 4.45 meters at the upper edge. Our heavy line lifts have two-stage telescopic lifting arms for extremely long vehicles. In general, both lifts are designed both for normal passenger cars and for vans, especially with long wheelbase. Iveco Daily, for example, or even campers. The lifting arms of the 6-ton model are 28 centimeters longer than those of the 5-ton model. They are thus designed for even longer vehicles. Furthermore, it must be mentioned that the front and rear lifting arms of the heavy line lifts are symmetrical, that is the same length. Not like the ones from the ProfiLine or the basic line, which have different lengths. Here we have symmetrical lifting arms. In addition, the lifting pads are a bit bigger, 2 centimeters bigger to be precise. Because, logically, the bigger the vehicle, the bigger the lifting point. The door protectors are also bigger because the bigger the vehicle, the bigger the doors. Otherwise, everything is actually the same with these lifts as with the ProfiLine. We also have the motor cover here. The same control unit, everything is the same. There's one important difference. In fact, we have a very special option for the heavy line lifts, namely this part here. This is a so-called wheel grip. This is very suitable if I want to do bodywork or something like that with the lift, because I grip the vehicle directly under the tire, and thus logically lift the car by its four tires. It adds the great benefit of having no lifting arms under the sill when I want to weld the sill, for example, because the arms would now be under the tires.
An den Schweller dran gehen, weil sie logischerweise hier an den Reifen sind. Da die Heavyline
Because the heavy line lifts are generally designed for wider and longer vehicles, the posts are logically a bit further apart, so the passage width of the 5 and 6 ton models is considerably larger than the one from the 4.2 and 3.6 ton models. I hope I could help you a bit further with this video. You now have the option of choosing a suitable lift below, if you have already decided on a specific model. Among other things, you'll find individual product videos and assembly videos for each lift. If you still have any questions or doubts, then you can always give us a call. Either I or one of my colleagues will help you further with any specific questions. Otherwise, thanks for watching.